accident, though. Only now, Captain Blush. That one is brand new. But that is for later, my friends, hey, because first... Yes. First, I'd like to subscribe to some viewers. Thanks for your support, for visiting our channel, for all your comments, for your subscriptions, and of course, for sharing and spreading the passion for the RC planes from this channel to the rest of the world. Welcome to Petrinčić Brothers, where we don't edit nothing. What you see is what you get. From day one, we turn the camera on and film this beautiful and sexy hobby, the best in the world, and that is flying RC planes. Eh? Once you see us on the runway, that means one thing. Of course, we're doing the maiden flight. Will this be the maiden flight or the maiden crash? Well, this time I don't think that we have to worry, because we have this beautiful and small and sexy, the best way to start in this hobby, mini P-47D Warbird from the Second World War. The plane that I can really recommend for you to be your first plane, because the point is not to present only here the big beasts and I don't know what, but also the planes, so we can persuade as many viewers as possible that comes to our channel to fly and try for the first time. And this time it's really, really special plane, eh? If you can start with the Warbird, I mean, this is unbelievable. But really, because it has the gyro in, maybe this can really be your first plane.
This is
Captain Blush.
Huh? This is uncrashable.
I mean, this is sick, eh? Of course, we have shown you the unboxing of this plane.
Be quick, because look at this, eh?
Be quick, of course, the wind is picking up, because this plane is a little different than other mini series, 400mm, because this one is 500mm, and this one even needs a little assembly, so you just get that mojo of assembly and you love the planes even more. This will be your first experience of the assembling of the plane. Of course, it must not be too sick, though you will lose your enthusiasm, but just enough to assemble little and have the ultimate fun later. All you have to do is put together the back, put two wheels in, two screws, put the back wheel in, put the wings in, you have here two more screws, and of course, plug the batteries
inside.
Plug the battery inside, and of course you must plug this, the ailerons and the on-off button here in this board. How do you call this board? No, this.
Oh yeah, this, yeah, motherboard.
On this motherboard, or I will call it something, it even comes with a beautiful real service. I mean, this is unbelievable. The beautiful paint job and all. Of course, if you check, now this, the point of this is that this is all in one box. Check the unboxing, you will see that inside this box you get it all. You get the plane, two batteries, you can also choose three. You will have the link below, so check quick, don't wait too long. Okay? You get the charger, the screwdriver, the wheels, and of course also the radio.
The wheels.
All that you need to start to fly. Even the instruction manual and everything. Eh?
The wheels.
Just a word or two about this plane. I mean, maybe there were discussions, because here it does have the P-47 Razorback. Now, of course, if you check this plane, it's not the Razorback. Uh-huh. In fact, it is the bubble top, because it does have here the cockpit in the way of the bubble. The Razorback did have the back from here to on top of the canopy to the cockpit, and the cockpit was even in the shape of the bird cage. That was the Razorback, but this is the bubble top. Now the point is, what's the point about this plane? Check the history, because this plane is amazing. A plane from the Second World War, but where's the beauty of this plane? This plane, in fact, was the heaviest in the history. The heaviest Warbird with the single engine, with the piston-driven single engine motor. This was the heaviest. At full load, with everything on, the bombs and everything, it weighed almost 8 tons.
Oh.
Can you imagine the size? If you check the silhouettes of this, I mean, this was really the biggest and the heaviest plane of the Second World War. All other Mustangs, Spitfires, Focke-Wulfs, they were almost half of the size of this plane. And the machine guns on this plane were so powerful. Then when it started, the machine gun started to fire on the ground. It was like the brakes on the plane. When the plane was diving, it was almost going back. The guns were so powerful. And I will tell you just one thing.
What?
Because of this hobby, we learn
this history.
So much new stuff we discovered.
Yeah, of course.
That is why I also love this. Can you imagine, my Captain Blush and my friends, I didn't know that, that fully loaded this plane, it could carry half of the bomb weight of the flying fortress.
Oh.
I mean, this is unbelievable. I didn't know this, and I'm impressed. And I will salute this plane. All the engineers, they are long gone. They're all that designed this plane, and all the pilots that were flying this. I mean, this is one mean flying machine, the beast. Now this one we can really call the beast. And from now on, that you know all these informations, and when you will check the history,
well, you will look at the plane differently.
And you will look at the plane totally differently. You will be even more impressed. You will even want it even more. You will want to have, I must click on that one, and not just this. The bigger sizes, bigger, I don't know what I mean. This is unbelievable. I mean, look at it.
And maybe now you will pull out your glow one, eh?
Hey, I have the glow one, I have the petrol one, and we have forgotten the last filming, Captain Blush. I have the third one.
Yes.
The FMS.
Didn't you buy that one?
1.7 meter one, the FMS, my friends. Hey, I have two bulls some more at home, and 1.5 meter, 1.6 meter, and 1.7 meter. I mean, this is unbelievable. This is unbelievable, eh? Huh? Enough of talking?
Yes, enough.
And now I will turn the radio on. Of course, first I will turn the plane on. Like I have shown you, this is the 4-channel plane. You will train everything that you need for the rest, for the next plane. You will train the ailerons, the elevator, the rudder, and of course the throttle. And if you have the good runway, some asphalt, look how good it rolls. Mm-hmm. You can even train takeoffs and landings, and this is unbelievable. Now, before I will fly, I will tell you one thing. You have here on the radio three position button, the beginner mode, the middle, and the advanced. Now, what does this mean? In the beginner mode, you have total control of the plane through the gyro.
Yes.
That means that your turns are really limited. Still, you will fly the plane, but it is really limited. On the middle position, you have more authority over the controls. And on the third, you turn the gyro off, but that is nothing. On all these planes, what I have discovered, it's almost impossible to fly them in the advanced mode because you won't have time to trim it. If you want to fly these planes in the advanced mode, do you know what you have to do?
No.
Get yourself an OpenTX radio.
Uh-huh.
Where you can bind this plane with the OpenTX, then you can set yourself the triple rates, and you can set yourself the expos. And then you can fly this plane exactly as the big one. Hey, I have the small P-51 Mustang set on the Radio Master radio, and now on the radio I can fly totally without the gyro, and I can do loops, the stunts, the inverted flight, whatever. But with this radio, I can't. And I don't think that even any of you will be able to. I mean, I will salute you if you can, but this radio is to fly in the middle or the beginner mode, and that's it.
Now
good enough.
It's now about
and now
to
let's
fly.
See this, because in fact...
It's time to fly. Because otherwise the winter will come.
Did you see this, eh?
Uh-huh.
Always you must turn first the plane on and then turn on the radio. And of course, at this point, you still don't have the gyro because you must initialize first the plane up and down.
Ah.
30% of throttle, and
Chuck,
now...
Is this gear-driven?
Oh, it is, of course, eh?
Ah, yes, look at this.
It is the gear-driven.
Uh-huh.
And of course, now we must see this. It is... This won't be fast as hell, don't expect, because it's still running on the same battery and I think maybe the same motor that the smaller ones, 400 millimeter ones.
Yeah.
So that means...
Do the smaller ones also have the gear
yeah, of course
the gear reduction?
Yeah. But I will tell you just one thing. If you want to set this plane to even try maybe in the advanced mode without the gyro, you know what you must do.
Mm.
If you want to do that, turn the battery on, put the plane in the advanced mode, and then set the ailerons, elevator, and everything. Otherwise, you won't have nothing. You must level the surfaces before on the plane, like on every other. Don't throw it in the air. Put it in the advanced mode and then think how I will now trim this. That will be nothing. You will fall down. Because, in fact, the gyro is working and leveling the plane. Now, if I just stuck this in the advanced mode like it was, the ailerons were all crooked. The elevator was up, the rudder was somewhere else, eh? But now, look, I have now the advanced mode, and look, everything is leveled like it should be. Do you see this?
Yes.
No more gyro, and now I will maybe try to switch without the gyro in the flight, but don't do that before you set yourself the travels. And one thing I will tell you, if you hear the one beep, 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 from time to time, that means that you have the low battery in the radio.
Uh-huh.
And if you hear the three quick beeps, tiddy, 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 that means that you will have the empty battery in the plane, and you still have 3 to 4 minutes to land. Now that means that you don't have to guess for how long and set yourself some extra timer for this plane. It will start to beep when the battery will dry low.
And now we will see the flight.
And now let's check the flight, of course, finally. But yes. First, runs! Right, left, up, down, left, right. And of course, a little throttle, and that's it. I will just throw it.
Yes, good luck.
With the gyro, it should work good, my friend say. So this is it, Captain Blush. Enough?
Yes.
Almost no wind, so who cares?
It does specification.
Have here some crazy return home button, but I won't try that. So this is it, Captain Blush?
Yes, not all or nothing.
I really hope for something, eh?
Go a bit more forward.
More forward?
Like this, yes.
But of course, this won't be the speed. It can't have, I don't know, speed as hell, because it's still on just on 1S battery. But it is a little bigger one. 500 milliamps. So this is it, Captain Lodge?
Yes.
Oh yeah!
This gear reduction sounds like a real engine, eh?
Yeah, but this is great, eh? Hey! Huh? Do you know what I can see here right now?
What?
That this is pretty no slight, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, I will have to put some little weight in front.
Maybe second battery, huh?
I don't know, eh? But look at this, eh? Huh? Hey, look. Do you see how it is a little nervous?
Mm-hmm.
Because of that, this is now the full speed. Yeah, but this is meant to be the fun, my friends, eh? Don't expect here, I don't know what, but still, eh?
Don't expect to go 100 yeah. miles an hour, eh?
Yeah, but why? If you're learning to fly and you don't need it, eh? That would scare you away. I will come once from the other side, eh? But it looks like a real one, huh?
Yes.
You know what I will do right now, eh?
What?
Should I land?
Why?
And put the extra battery in?
Yeah, I don't know.
Or just fly it, eh? Like it is, eh? Oh, little rudder, look. Oh! Hey, it turns much better with the little rudder, eh? But how can you tell when it's in the air, eh? You can't tell.
The size, huh?
The size of this, eh? Tell me.
No.
It looks like a 2 meter wingspan. Look.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I just love these plans. My friends say this is just to relax after some serious flights before this. When you end with your flights with some jets maybe or something, when you're all nervous or the fast planes, then you just take this out, eh? From the car and look. Yeah, but it looks like a real one, huh?
Yes, very good. Very, very realistic in the air.
Ah, do you see this? How it is? A little nervous? The back of the plane, just because of that, because the CG is not perfect. It wants to climb. Do you know what I will do right now, eh? I will land, wait.
Yeah.
I will go back, sexy. And I will land, eh? Then I will stuck in.
Another battery?
I will change the battery for the fresh one. And I will use one.
Perfect. You don't need to put the fresh one. This will last a little bit more.
Yeah, but if I put another one in... If I put another one in... Hey, don't worry, Captain Watch. We won't fly for 10 minutes. But I just want to see. If I stuck in two batteries... Because I think... That this will help a lot, eh? Because you have seen... You have seen, or maybe I will just tuck the second battery in. You have seen that it really flies like this, and then it's nervous when you want to level it. So that means that there is something.
Well, that hook is holding the canopy. Oh, yeah. Are you
really
hungry?
Good, eh?
Are you hungry?
It holds really good, eh? And now I will stuck in the second battery, and I'm pretty sure my friends say that this.
Will be enough.
That this will help a lot, eh? I mean, it will be better if it will not be perfect. I just hope it won't go...
It doesn't mess with the cables.
I don't want to mess too much. I just don't want that this will fall out in the flight. I will put it in like this. It must be in front of the CG, you know. Like this, and I don't want it to go back.
Like
now let's try quick. If this will help. Now I didn't get it too much far, but I think that still it is
good enough, huh?
I think it is, huh? If it is here, then it is in front of the CG. And I really wonder right now, eh?
What's
if this will help, eh? Are you ready?
Yes.
Pretty much better. Look at this, eh? It could go even more.
Yeah.
To the front, but look, it behaves. Do you see how it behaves much better than before?
Differently.
Look. Now I have something, eh? Because I don't know, it's useless. It would be useless to trim it with the gyro. Tell me that is it good now, huh?
Yes.
The best way I will tell you to fly these planes is, of course, with the full throttle, and that's it, eh? They fly the best. Now it behaves 50% better, I will tell you this, eh? It just needed a little more.
It even looks better in the air than it did before.
Is it? Than before, eh? I mean, this is great solution, my friend, say. You don't even have to worry what to put, just stuck two batteries in.
Or maybe get a bigger battery, huh?
It will be good to put even bigger battery. I will check if I have something at home.
It will even give me a bit better flying time, eh? Hey, but this is sick, eh? Huh?
Mm-hmm.
That's it, Captain Blush.
Yes.
One more pass. From this side, for the viewers, low and sexy. One from the other side, and maybe I will just
land from that side.
Well, why not?
Hey, good enough.
Yeah, okay. For the size of the plane, eh? Not bad.
No. As I said, I like the that sound of that gear that is working in front.
Yeah, but the best thing is that it's really such a joy and a relaxing flight. I mean, I just love it, eh?
And plus, it's very hard to crash this, huh? Even if it fell from down from the sky.
Yeah, you can't. And that is just now you have seen. Now, maybe you wonder why I did put, just put the camera up there. Why I did put, That's good thing that I don't even have to pull out the batteries. I can just switch off the plane, switch off the radio, and that's it, eh?
Yeah.
Now we can talk, eh? I mean, I just love this switch, eh? This is very big plus on this plane, eh? Now I will tell you why I did put the wheels on, of course, in the air. Well, it doesn't look so sexy like the plane without the wheels, but I did put them on just to protect the
propeller,
the prop on the landings, because...
Even though I think that you get two, huh?
Yeah, you get two propellers. But why to screw the prop? Just put the wheels on and you will not hit the prop every time you will land. Because I have learned this from the smaller ones. Almost every single time that I land, the prop falls off. It is made in such a way so it falls off.
It but has not a prop on this saver.
One. Yeah, but not on this one. This one you must screw the prop on. So
no.
I don't want to screw it too much. Just put the wheels on and that's it, eh? Hey, I mean, it's unbelievable. Eh?
Hey, even I will fly this next time.
Hey. And you know what I will do the next time?
What?
I will try to find the bigger battery.
Or maybe just put some nut in front.
Or maybe some
M10 nut, M12.
I can just put it here somewhere, in front something, because I have seen now, my friends, that even two batteries, that even with the two batteries in front,
MDC, it not going to be direct.
Yeah, but this is for the cooling, maybe.
Yeah, to cool what? There is nothing inside.
Yeah. No, leave it like it is, Captain Blush. Yeah.
Yeah, now you can put this one because the motor.
Yeah.
Is
because
front.
Look at this, the battery is still here.
Yes, in top.
I will try to stuck the first battery all the way forward that I can, and maybe stuck also this one all the way forward. If both batteries were here in the front, then maybe I would have the perfect CG. Because even with the two batteries, you have seen now that I was flying with the two batteries, and still it was feeling a little nose light. So that means that next time stuck in the bigger battery, or put on some weight, and you will see in the flight when this plane will fly good. You will have the feeling if it is okay or not, and then you can switch off the gyro. But of course, for the next flight with this plane, do you know what I will do? I will get the good CG, and of course, I will bind this one with an OpenTX radio. I will set myself on the triple travels, the expo and all, and then we will see if we can do some crazy loops and rolls and I don't know what with this plane. And I do believe that we will be able to do that, as long as we will find the perfect CG.
So this is it,
what to tell at the end, the assessment from 0 to 10, eh? I can give this plane, I will give it 9 without any problems, eh? It looks sexy, it flies good with the gyro, all that we need here now is the perfect CG, and that's it, eh? And you will have the time of your life. And I can really recommend this one, like I have said,
all that you need in one box, say, to start to learn to assemble planes and to start to learn to fly them. Usually in the past we have started to fly with the high-wing planes, but why not? You can even start with the Warbird like this. Yeah. Eh?
And there are gyros working for you, so yeah. No problem, eh?
So that's it. But you still learn how to use the ailerons, the rudder, the elevator, the throttle, and of course the difference if you fly towards you or if you fly away from you, because that's the point, eh? So this is it, eh?
Yes.
And pretty good, my friends, eh? Pilot Robert and Captain Blas signing off from Slovenia with beautiful and sexy Ishin P-47D bubble top. Amazing plane.
Bubble boy.
Bubble boy from the Ishin. The link you have below. The biggest and the heaviest single engine piston driven Warbird from the Second World War. That was really, really a badass plane, and if you don't have another version, well, I think that your hangar deserves to have at least this one. It doesn't cost much, and believe me, if you will just hang it in your office or in your room, in your living room, put it around the TV or somewhere, you will pay the tribute to all the veterans from the Second World War and all the pilots that were flying this kind of planes.
Yes.
This is Captain Blush. Cut quick! We still have one more to film. The wind has stopped. We don't have too much sun, but it will be enough for that video, because only if we will be quick, Captain Blush.
Yes.
Viewers, we love you all, of course. Expect more pretty soon, eh?